Hi Pisces, welcome to your monthly reading. As always, keep in mind that this is only a general reading. Always take what feels right and with what does resonate within your own life experiences during this time. If you would like to have a personal reading with me, please contact me through the email I put in the description box below. For the month of November, as usual, I have a special sales offer available. And for this month, it's inspired in the current Scorpio season we are on. If you would like to know more details about it, you can read in the description box where you can also find the full list of current reading services I offer. And if you would like to donate and support my channel, you can also do that by following the PayPal link, which is also down below. So Pisces, I feel like there's major changes coming up for you during the month of November. Some of them wanted, some of them not so much. It's like you're trying to balance here between good experiences of change versus unforeseen ones that might lead you to feel that your sense of security or your sense of self even is disrupted. So there's a little bit of a duality you're holding throughout the whole month, very consciously. I feel like some of you, this is about the major it's like you're breaking free from a major situation that has been limiting you. And it could be a major breakup for some of you. So there might be a huge breakup for some of you that are in a partnership or in an association with someone that has felt very restrictive. I feel like your soul is ready to break this bond. The Tower is in your soul position. You're very agitated throughout November. You're feeling things intensely. And again, I keep getting like there's moments where you feel things intensely that are very positive. With the sun in your center of your reading, it's like you feel intensely. You feel the passion. You're certain. You're clear on your goals, on your desires, on what you should do. But then unconsciously, you're still kind of working through insecurities, deep-seated insecurities that keep you, you know, bound to an energy where you feel poor, left out, abandoned, forsaken from energies that should be a part of your life, so such as love and financial prosperity and respect and appreciation and friends and a sense of community to be a part of. So there's a lot of things you're struggling with at the same time, and in the middle of this still trying to find balance. So it's a month where you're asked, you're advised to work with yourself and with the things going on with a lot of patience and a lot of gentleness, because the energy is very volatile itself, so you don't want to make it harder than what already is. But I also feel like you have been in situations that really ended a while ago with the Death Arcana in your recent past, so this is about you coming to the front and actually leaving it, or someone doing this for you. So it's like something that has ended, you know, its purpose, its function in your life has ended a while ago, but maybe there hasn't been like this assuming of this ending or this confrontation with the ending itself that maybe led you into a spiral of denial or a repressed truth that now is coming out. It's like a lot of things that have been avoided, looking at or assuming, it's now very clear out in the obvious, and it could be you instilling this or someone triggering this Tower moment and making it very clear to you that you need to let certain things go or fall apart in order to actually access the freedom and the freedom and the success at the same time that also you're very centered on. Because I feel like there's two, again, I keep getting two parallel things happening at the same time. Something negative, difficult to process, difficult to deal with, and another one that's very exciting. So there can be like this new discovery of a sense of purpose or a new career opportunity, a new venture you're getting yourself into, or you moving into a new place that really activates a lot of hope and a lot of happiness in your life, especially if there's a lot of sunshine in this place, or if you pursue a creative aspiration, or if you get to move in a direction of something that represents the sun to you, that it's warm. I feel like for some of you Pisces, you know better than what you have been doing. So it's like, and now you're going to be like actualizing this. You're going to start doing things that you know are for the best of you and of your life. So no more relapsing into behaviors or conditions that only take you down into the five of pentacles, where you're not, it's like you don't feel deserving of the good things. You see other people passing by with all their, you know, pentacles and fortune and love, whatever it is that you most crave right now that you feel you don't have, but you don't get up. It's like when we are indulging in our own sense of misery, right, in our poor me mentality. And this is in the unconscious, so it's not like you're doing this, obviously, for many of you, not doing this purposefully, but that's the underlying reasons why the Tower and certain events that are more uncomfortable might be taking place, is for you to have that rude awakening of, look, stop with this. You're not less than anyone, and look at what's waiting for you. You know, the Fool and the Sun, major cards of excitement, of success, of freedom, of being able to do whatever you want to do. So it's like there's a sense that, again, that you have been in a very limited space, being internally, like doing this to yourself, or allowing an abusive situation, allowing something outside of you to make you believe that you couldn't access or achieve certain things, such as a life of your dreams. And I feel like there could be at times a sensation of your mental health being a little bit affected, obviously, by all these changes going on and all these different elements taking place. I feel like at times you might feel like you're losing it or close to, or you might feel like you don't know what's real. It's like you don't know what's real versus what's not, or how to differentiate what are the good things, or the good changes, the good people versus what isn't. So I see a lot of, it's like at times a lot of darkness around your mental space. That's why the sun is in the center of your reading, because when you connect with your essence, when you connect with your solar plexus in particular, like your willpower, your sense of self, your sense of purpose, the sun, your sense of purpose, where no darkness can get near of, is that energy of when you really are connected with your sun, nothing can make you question, or very, very little things can make you question who you are, what you're deserving of, and especially what you should be doing. It's like a sense of certainty around what you should be doing with yourself and with your life is major here. If this is about a breakup, I feel like it's like for the best. Like I keep getting like the energies of it's for the best, at least for the time being, until there's a major reset going on here with your own self. You need to figure, especially who you are after this relationship situation. So it could be, even if it's not a love partnership, but like a business association or a big old time, you know, friendship that comes to, I'm sorry, comes to an end. Before any mending could happen, before any possibility of reconciliation can happen, you need to heal, but you also need to figure who you are, because I feel like for some of you Pisces, there has been relationships really robbing you of your sense of identity, and now it's like you're kind of restoring that. So I hope you have a great month. Hopefully we'll see each other soon.